السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح الله أكبر
الحمد لله نحمده تعالى ونستغفره ونستعينه ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا Praise be to Allah. We praise him and ask for his support and his forgiveness. We seek refuge in Allah from the evil of our souls and wrongdoings. Whomever Allah guides will never be led astray, and whomever Allah leaves astray, no one can guide. I bear witness there is no one worthy of worship but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and I bear witness that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is his messenger. O people, be pious to Allah. By doing his commands and avoiding what he forbids. Allah says, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اتَّقُوا اللَّهَ حَقَّ تُقَاتِهِ وَلَا تَمُوتُنَّ إِلَّا وَأَنْتُمْ مُسْلِمُونَ O you who have believed, fear Allah as he should be feared, and do not die except as Muslims in submission to him. He also said, يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسُ اتَّقُوا رَبَّكُمُ الَّذِي خَلَقَكُم مِّن نَّفْسٍ وَاحِدَةٍ وَخَلَقَ مِنْهَا زَوْجَهَا وَبَثَّ مِنْهُمَا رِجَالًا كَثِيرًا وَنِسَاءً O my kind, be pious to Allah, who created you from one soul, and created from it its mate, and made from both many men and women. Brothers, sisters, and children, we have all experienced in our life the fight between the good and the bad, and the intertwined between the good and the evil, and the conflict between the soldier of Rahman and the soldier of Satan. Allah explains that this is for a reason. He subhanahu wa ta'ala says, لِيَقْضِيَ اللَّهُ أَمْرًا كَانَ مَفْعُولًا لِيَهْلِكَ مَنْ هَلَكَ عَنْ بَيِّنَهُ وَيَحْيَ مَنْ حَيَّ عَنْ بَيِّنَهُ So that Allah might accomplish a matter of already distant, that those who perished that those who perished through disbelief would perish upon evidence, and those who lived in faith would live upon evidence. However, this leaves the believers only to increase appreciation to the truth and obedience to be righteous. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, أَمْ نَجْعَلُ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ كَالْمُفْسِدِينَ فِي الْأَرْضِ أَمْ نَجْعَلُ الْمُتَّقِينَ كَالْفُجَّارِ. Or should we treat those who believe and do righteous deeds like corruptors in the land? Or should we treat those who fear Allah like the wicked ones? This is why it is of our noble principle and profound teachings that we should be proud of our religion, to feel honored by Allah and as Muslims. Those who don't have this feeling are in doubt and distrust. Allah says, وَإِنَّهُ لَذِكْرٌ لَكَ وَلِقَوْمِكَ. And indeed, it is a remembrance for you and your people. It is an honor for you and your people, and honor to your followers. We should be honored. We have Quran for being of the Quranic Ummah, the Islamic community. Dear Muslims, Allah wanted the believers to rise and rise in this world and hereafter. He subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَلَا تَهِنُوا وَلَا تَحْزَنُوا وَأَنْتُمُ الْعَلَوْنَ إِن كُنْتُم مُؤْمِنِينَ. So don't weaken and don't grieve. You are superior if you are true believers. Allah has chosen highness for the believers because they are more worthy of it than the others. He chosen them no one will stand for his religion as they do. He's chosen them because only they will be defended. They are the guardians of this humanity, the protector of it. They are the guiders to everyone, to take them from darkness to light by Allah's will. He subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَكَانَ حَقًّا عَلَيْنَا نَصْرُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. It is required upon us to support the believers. He also said, وَلَيَنْصُرَنَّ اللَّهُ مَنْ يَنْصُرُهُ إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَقَوِيٌّ عَزِيزٌ. And Allah will surely support those who support him. Indeed, Allah is the powerful and blessed in mind. My talk today is to you and about you, brothers, sisters, and children. The one sitting in front of me and listening to me, and I'm asking, do we know who we are? It is not a question about your name and family. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, فَإِذَا نُفِخَ فِي الصُّورِ فَلَا أَنْسَابَ بَيْنُهُمْ. So when the horn is blown, no relationship will there be among them. It's not about the origin or country or the noble heritage. That didn't help Abu Lahab, even though he was the prophet's uncle. He is in hell. While Bilal, the African slave in Mecca, has the highest respect among Allah and Muslims. So I want to talk to you, my Muslim brothers and sisters, who occupy the highest place in earth and carry the most honorable medal, which is belonging to the religion of Islam. When you become a Muslim, you bear a gift and honor from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And what an honor it is for you, that is nothing greater than being recognized by Allah and being called by his word subhanahu wa ta'ala in his book. He subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلَقَدْ أَنزَلْنَا إِلَيْكُمْ كِتَابًا فِيهِ ذِكْرِكُمْ. We certainly sent down to you a book in which you are mentioned. Can there be any greater honor than that Allah chosen the best man he ever created and sent him to us to guide us on the straight path directly to him subhanahu wa ta'ala? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, لَقَدْ مَنَّ اللَّهُ عَلَى الْمُؤْمِنِينَ إِذْ بَعَثَ فِيهِمْ رَسُولًا مِّنْ أَنفُسِهِمْ يَتْلُوا عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتِهِ وَيُعْلِمُهُمْ الْكِتَابَ وَالْحِكْمَةَ. Certainly Allah gave a great favor upon the believers when he sent among them a messenger from themselves, reciting to them his verses and purifying them and teaching them the book and wisdom. Oh, brothers and sisters, Allah has honored you and secured you and made the protection of your life one of the greatest. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَمَنْ يَقْتُلْ مُؤْمِنًا مُتَعَمِّدًا فَجَزَاهُ جَهَنَّمَ خَالِدًا فِيهَا وَغَضِبَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَلَعَنَهُ وَعَدَّ لَهُ عَذَابًا عَظِيمًا. But whoever kills a believer on purpose, his punishment is hell, wherein he will live forever, and Allah have become angry with him and has cursed him and has prepared for him a great punishment. You are the ones whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has declared that the worth of your life is greater than the value of the whole world, and a drop of your blood is greater to him subhanahu wa ta'ala than the holiness of his great house, the Kaaba. Oh, how great you are, dear Muslims, and how dear you are. If you really know your destiny, if you really connect to the one who glorifies, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yes, you, dear Muslims, you are the highest of all nations. Your faith is higher as you are the true worshipper of Allah, the greatest, while others worship one of his creators, his creations. Your laws are the best as you apply the laws sent from Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala, while others have laws made by men. Your role is at the top as you are the guardians of humanity. I would like to tell you about this case of one companion, so please listen. In the Battle of Ahzab, which refers to united parties against Islam, things were so bad and scary. Conditions were so much against Muslims. Eyes crossed and hearts frightened, and the believers felt this is the end of them. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam thought of ways to ease the plight. So he sent a message to Uyayn ibn Husayn, who was with the Kuffar, asking if he would back up his troops if he was to be given a third of Medina's dates. He replied he would if he's given half of the dates. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam called for Sa'd ibn Ubadah and Sa'd ibn Mu'adh, the leaders of Medina, and told them about the deal. They asked, O Messenger of Allah, is this something you love? Then we will accept. Or is it Allah's command? Then we will follow. What is this something you do for the sake of us? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, it is something I do for your sake, as I saw the Arabs are united against you. They said, O Messenger of Allah, we used to deal with these people, and we were all kafirs, and we worship the idols. No one knew of Allah nor worshipped him. They never thought of eating one date unless it was a hospitality or a sale deal. Now we are honored by Allah and Islam, and we are guided to him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. He has honored us by having you. Now you think we will give them our money? By Allah, we don't need this. This is the only thing we offer them is the sword and Allah, until Allah rules them. Yes, dear Muslims, it is sufficient for us that we worship Allah and follow his messenger, and we hope we serve the light and spread the light to all manhood. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has sent Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with guidance and the religion of truth to all people of the earth. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَذْكُرُوا إِذْ أَنْتُمْ قَلِيلًا قَلِيلٌ مُسْتَضْعَفُونَ فِي الْأَرْضِ تَخَافُونَ أَنْ يَتَخَطَّفَكُمُ النَّاسِ فَأَوَاكُمْ وَأَيَّدَكُمْ بِنَصْرِهِ وَرَزَقَكُمْ مِنَ الطَّيِّبَاتِ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَشْكُرُونَ. And you remember when you were few and oppressed in the land, feeling that people might abduct you, but he sheltered you and supported you with his victory and provided you with good things that you might be grateful. By the time of his death, sallallahu alayhi wasallam, Islam was well spread all over Arabia. Shirk and misguidance diminished. Islam became strong and dear. Islam was carried after him by his companions to all corners of the globe. And Allah made his religion victorious and led his word to the highest levels and verified his promise, as he says, لِيُظْهِرَهُ عَلَى الدِّينِ كُلِّهِ وَلَوْ كَرِهَ الْكَافِرُونَ وَلَوْ كَرِهَ الْمُشْرِكُونَ. To make it apparent over all religions, despite the will of those who associated others with Allah and their dislike of it. Allah would raise Islam and humiliate disbelievers. He says, وَلَا تَهِنُوا وَلَا تَحْزُنُوا وَأَنْتُمُ الْأَعْلَوْنَ إِن كُنْتُمْ مُؤْمِنِينَ. So don't weaken and don't grieve. You are the superior if you are true believers. The religion of Islam, dear Muslims, is the religion of pride. Therefore, it is forbidden for a Muslim to appear as a weakened one. Islam advises against any situation that undermines his dignity or puts him in a disgrace. Islam places the believer in a stable place where he has full freedom. A Muslim is obliged to seek this opportunity in his environment. When it becomes impossible, he has to turn away from the land of shame and look for dignity elsewhere. But the pride of the Muslim in himself, in his religion, in his Lord, is the pride of different kind. It is the pride of faith, not of arrogance and oppression. to overcome weakness and belittling, to deny any place of disgrace, or to be a follower of others. It is the pride of rising above the earthly temptation and the worldly claims that the many vanities of this life which are praised by other people. It is the pride and honor to save Muslims and be easy with them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us that all glory for him. The means to gain it is to speak well and do good. قال تعالى من كان يريد العزة فلله العزة جميعا. Whoever desires honor through power, then to Allah belongs all power. Allah Almighty rejected those who thought the honor and supremacy are in collecting funds and the position of worldly affairs. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَقَالُوا لَوْلَا نُزِّلَ هَذَا الْقُرْآنِ عَلَى رَجُلٍ مِّنَ الْقَرَيْتَيْنِ عَظِيمٍ. And they said, why was this Quran not sent down upon a great man from one of the two cities? They didn't like the Prophet. Complete honor is not in the big house or in palaces, nor in money, nor in a big family, nor in the shapes of the strong bodies. It is to be a true slave to Allah, the Lord of earth and heavens. It is to be a follower of Allah's commands, those who do good deeds and avoid forbidden things. Islam has placed in high recognition Bilal, who was African, Salman, who was Persian, and Suhaib, who was Roman, without looking at their heritage. He placed in humiliation and disgrace Abu Jahl, Utbah, and Abu Lahab, and didn't recognize their nobility in their tribes because they were kafirs and denied Allah. Abdullah ibn Umm Maktum, who was a poor blind man, approached the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, asking him to teach him Islam, while the Prophet was busy with the leaders of Kufr, inviting them to the straight path to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Prophet turned away from him because he didn't want to miss this opportunity with the leaders of Kufr. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala denounced this act, accusing the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam of frowning at the poor man. Allah said, عَبَسَ وَتَوَلَّى أن جاءه الأعمى وما يدريك لعله يزكى أو يذكر فتنفعه الذكرى. He frowned and turned away because there came up to him a blind man interrupting. But what would make you perceive, O Muhammad, that perhaps he might be purified or be reminded, and the remembrance would benefit him. Who told you about this case? Perhaps he wanted to be purified and get the benefit of the knowledge, and to understand the religion. He wanted you to lead him to Allah. أما من استغنى فأنت له تصدى وما عليك ألا يزكى. As for this who thinks himself without need, to whom you give attention, and not upon you is any blame if he will not be purified. As for the kafirs who are interested in this message, as for the kafirs who are not interested in this message and guidance, those people you face and gave attention. You received them and were pleasure and willing to attend them. وَأَمَّا مِنْ جَاءَكَ يَسْعَى وَهَوْ يَخْشَى فَأَنْتَ عَنْهُ تَلَهَى. But as for who came to you striving for knowledge while he fears Allah, from him you were distracted. So the Prophet was willing to attend to the strong figures, but the blind poor man he ignored and turned away, even though he wasn't blamed that they are not interested. It's their problem, and they will die with kufr and stubbornness and arrogance. No, don't attend to the powerful believers and ignore the blind poor man who is sincerely seeking faith. So when Abdullah came again, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa stood up to greet him, hugged him, and laid the rug for him to sit. And then on whenever the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would meet him, he would say, welcome my brother, whom Allah blamed me for not attending. Indeed, the result was that those people, those leaders, died as kafirs, entered the hellfire, as mentioned in the Quran. Abdullah ibn Umm Maktum, on the other hand, accepted Islam and continued his faith and loyalty. When it was time to promote Islam outside Arabia, and Muslims were spreading it into Persia, Umar radiallahu anhu called for men to attend the Battle of Qadisiyah, which was the turning point with Caesar and Persia and their commanders Rustam. When Umar called, Abdullah ibn Umm Maktum enlisted in the troops. The companion told him, the companions told him, you are excused as you are a blind man. He said, no. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, unfuru khifafan wa thiqala. Go forth, whether light or heavy. When he came to the battle, he asked to carry the flag and to be placed in the front row. As he said, he was blind and would not see the approaching army. Thus, he would not flinch or be afraid. He asked to stand in a hole in the ground to face the enemies. This is where he stood. This is where he stood until he was killed with his grave under his feet. May Allah be pleased with him, with this faithful companion and faith seeker, one who was honored by Islam and became a symbol for the truth. When you meet a pious person, your heart will love him if you're a true believer. As you feel the light and kindness on him. The companions radiallahu anhum did not own much of the worldly earnings. Some did not even have a piece of bread. They would sleep in the open desert. But Allah had looked into their hearts and guided them to the truth. When Jalabib, the companion, came to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he smiled at him and said, O Jalabib, do you want to get married? He said, O Messenger of Allah, who is going to accept me? I have no money, I have no family, no house, no possessions. The Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam told him, go to a certain house and give them the greeting of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and tell them that the Prophet commands you to marry me. He went and knocked on their doors. They were one of the noble families. And when the head of the house saw Jalabib, he noticed his poor appearance, reflecting his poverty and need. He asked him, what do you need? Jalabib told him the case. He went back to his family to consult them how to answer the Prophet. They wished it was anyone but Jalabib, a man with no family and no wealth. The daughter of the man who grew up in Islam said, how can you reject a messenger of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? I will marry him. They get married and built a house which was founded on piety of Allah and pleasing him day and night. Later on, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam attended a battle of Islam. When it ended with victory, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said to the companions, is there anyone missing? They said, yes, so and so are missing. Then he asked again, is anyone missing? They said, yes, so and so is missing. And then he asked for the third time, is anyone missing? They said, no. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, but I miss Jalabib. go look for him. They found him dead between seven bodies of kafirs. They brought the body to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who stood up and said, seven kafirs were killed by him. Then they killed him. This man is part of me, and I am part of him. Then sallallahu alaihi wasallam carried the body in his blessed arm, and didn't let anybody bury him but him. May Allah be pleased with this other faithful companion and faith seeker, one who was honored by Islam and became a symbol for the truth. In the time of pride and strength, Rustum, the kafir commander of Persia, has an army of 280,000 soldiers at the Battle of Qadisiyah against the Muslims. He said to Sa'd ibn Abi Waqqas, the Muslim leaders who had only 30,000 soldiers, send one of your soldiers to talk to me. He sent Rabi'i ibn Amr, a 30-year-old poor man and a companion of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Sa'd told him, go and do not change any of your appearance, because Allah has honored us by Islam. And if we seek honor in anything else, Allah will humiliate us. When Rustam was informed of his arrival, he gathered around him the ruling family, ministers, and soldiers, and prepared things to intimidate Rabi'i ibn Amr and impress him with greatness, with the intention to humiliate him and make him stutter and unable to speak. After Rustam took his seat, he said, bring him. Rabi'i entered leading his horse and using his spear as a walking stick, pressing it into expensive rugs to demonstrate that his worldly matters does not mean a thing to him and has no value. When Rabi'i stood facing Rustam, Rustam said, sit down. Rabi'i said, I didn't come as a guest, I'm a messenger. Rustam said,
We never heard of you among civilized people. You are the least of all people. The Romans has civilization. So do the Persians, the Greeks, and the Indians. But you are the people of the desert. You chase sheep and camels. So what brought you up here? Rabi'i said, "Yes, O king, we were as you said, and worse. We were ignorant people. We worshipped idols and killed relatives for the supply of water. We had no law and order, nor any civilization." He added with a clear and loud voice, "Then Allah sent us to guide people away from worshipping the slaves of Allah to worshipping the Lord of slaves, and from the narrowness of the westward to the spacious of hereafter, and from the injustice of man's law to the justice of Islam." Rustum got angry and threw a dust on the rug on him and ordered him to leave. When he reached Sa'd, he said, What is on your head, O Rabi'i?" He said, "It is dust from the land of Rustum." He said, "Allahu Akbar." And all Muslims repeated it, so much their camp was shaking and all screaming, "You have brought back a sample of the land. We will be victory, and they will be handing over their land, and by Allah's will." In the early morning, as the sun was rising with victory, Sa'd radiallahu anhu was in the first row. As the two armies met, Allah Almighty showed his mercy on his party. At the end of the 3 days of war, the battalions of the misguided were crushed. Allah says, فَقُطِعَ دَابِرُ الْقَوْمُ الَّذِينَ ظَلَمُوا وَالْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. So the people that committed wrong were eliminated, and praise to Allah, the Lord of all worlds. On the fourth day, Sa'd entered the saloon of Caesar, who ruled the world for 1,000 years. It was full of gold, jewelries. Sa'd cried and recited, كَمْ تَرَكُوا مِنْ جَنَّاتٍ وَعِيُونَ وَزُرُوعٍ وَمَقَامٍ كَرِيمٍ وَنِعْمَةٍ كَانُوا فِيهَا فَاكِهِينَ كَذَلِكَ وَوَرَثْنَاهَا قَوْمًا آخَرِينَ فَمَا بَكَتْ عَلَيْهِمْ السَّمَاءُ وَالْأَرْضُ وَمَا كَانُوا مُنْظَرِينَ. How much they left behind of gardens and springs and crops and noble sites, and comfort within they were amused. Thus, and we caused it to inherit to another people. And the heavens and the earth wept not for them, nor were they pardoned. True pride settles in the heart before it appears on people. It rises above all sources of humiliation and does not bow to anything other than Allah. It is something the believer uses to keep himself away from all sources of disgrace. Once a person rises above this, no one will have the meanings of humiliation and overpower him. I have said what you heard, and I ask forgiveness from Allah for me and the Muslims for all of our sins. So ask him for forgiveness and repent to him. He is most merciful. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله يا بعد. عباد الله اتقوا الله تعالى واطيعوه ولا تعصوه. Praise be to Allah and peace be upon Messenger and blessings be upon him and his family and companions. Allah says, وَمَنْ يَتَّقِ اللَّهَ يَجْعَلْ لَهُ مَخْرَجًا. And whoever fears Allah, he will make for him a way out. Dear people, we know that pride is an Islamic principle and a respected moral. We should also know that all glory is for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and none of it is for anyone else. Whoever wants to be proud should ask it from the source. We should seek it from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The respected ones in this world and hereafter are the ones who are given respect by Allah Almighty. He says, قُلِ اللَّهُمَّ مَالِكُ الْمُلْكِ تُؤْتِي الْمُلْكَ مَنْ تَشَاءُ. Say, O Allah, honor of sovereignty, you give sovereignty to whom you will, and you will take it away from whom you will. With obedience to Allah, pride is increased. The most precious people are the prophets and those who follow them from the believers. Pride of each is as high as his rank in religion. So be pious to Allah and be supporters of Allah. Surely you are the one of the last defenders of this religion. If you give up, Allah will abandon you. Allah says, والله الغني وأنتم الفقراء وإن تتولوا يستبدل قوما غيركم ثم لا يكونوا أمثالكم. And Allah is free of need while you are the needy. And if you turn away, He will replace you with another people. Then they will not be like you. We must build our homes and, on the teachings of Islam and its laws. We need to respect the rituals of Allah and engrave it in our hearts. We need to recognize the boundaries that Allah commanded to keep. Here are some ways to do that. To raise in our hearts the name of Allah Almighty and know Him as much of His names and attributes. Also show respect to the Quran, the book of Allah. The same goes to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, his sunnah and his seerah. And the same goes towards the respect of the companions, Abu Bakr, Umar, Uthman, and Ali, and all the others, radhiyallahu alayhim, to the point where these great people become models for us and our children and families. Allah says, أُولَٰئِكَ الَّذِينَ هَدَهُمُ اللَّهِ فَبِهُدَاهِمْ اقْتَدَىٰ. Those are the ones whom Allah has guided, so from their guidance, take an example. Dear brothers and sisters, we must know the meanings of pride so we can be among those whom were described in the Quran. Allah says, Muhammadur Rasulullah walladhina ma'ahu ashidda'u 'ala al-kuffar rahamahu bainahum tarahum ruk'an sujudan yabtaghuna fadlan min Allah wa ridwana simahum fi wujuhihim min athari sujud. Muhammad is the messenger of Allah, and those with him are forceful against the disbelievers, merciful among themselves. You see them bowing and praying, seeking provisions from Allah and His pleas. Their mark is on their faces from the tears of praying. Dear Muslims, remember that Allah has commanded you to pray for the Prophet. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّ اللَّهَ وَمَلَائِكَتَهُ يُصَلُّونَ عَلَى النَّبِيِّ يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا صَلُّوا عَلَيْهِ وَسَلِّمُوا تَسْلِيمًا. Indeed, Allah confers blessing upon the Prophet, and His angel ask him to do so. O you who have believed, ask Allah to confer blessing upon him and ask Allah to grant him peace. Peace and blessing be upon him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Warad Allahumma an al-khalafai al-arba'ati al-rashidina Abu Bakr wa Umar wa Uthman wa Ali. Wa an tabi'ina wa man tabi'ahum bi ihsanin ila yawm al-deen. Wa anna ma'ahum bi'afrika wa karamika wa ihsanika ya arhamar rahimin. Allahumma aghfir lil mu'minina wal mu'minat. Al-ahya'a minhum wal amwat. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. واجعلنا اللهم هداة المهتدين غير ضالين ولا مضلين. اللهم استر عوراتنا وآمن روعاتنا واكفنا شر همومنا وأهوائنا. عباد الله، إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. فاذكروا الله يذكركم واشكروه على نعيمه يزدكم. ولذكر الله أكبر، الله يعلم ما تصنعون. وأقم الصلاة.
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الرحمن الرحيم
مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين. ألم تر إلى الذين أوتوا نصيبا من الكتاب يدعون إلى كتاب الله ليحكم بينهم ثم تولى فريق منهم وهم معرضون ذلك بأنهم قالوا لن تمسنا النار إلا أياما معدودات وغرهم في دينهم ما كانوا يفترون فكيف إذا جمعناهم ليوم لا ريب فيه ووفيت كل نفس ما كسبت وهم لا يظلمون قل اللهم مالك الملك تؤتي الملك من تشاء وتنزع الملك ممن تشاء وتعز من تشاء وتذل من تشاء بيدك الخير إنك على كل شيء قدير تولج الليل في النهار وتولج النهار في الليل وتخرج الحي من الميت وتخرج الميت من الحي وترزق من تشاء بغير حساب الله سمع الله لمن حمده
الله أكبر الله الله أكبر
الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين. قل إن تخفوا ما في صدوركم أو تبدوه يعلمه الله ويعلم ما في السماوات وما في الأرض والله على كل شيء قدير يوم تجد كل نفس ما عملت من خير محضرا وما عملت من سوء تود لو أن بينها وبينه أمدا بعيدا ويحذركم الله نفسه والله رؤوف بالعباد قل إن كنتم تحبون الله فاتبعوني فاتبعوني يحببكم الله ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم والله غفور رحيم. الله سمع الله لمن حمده.
الله أكبر. الله الله أكبر. الله السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.